ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who brought us together, to gather us in Jannatul Firdaus, insha'Allah. Ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Dear respected brothers and sisters, welcome back to another virtual iftar. And alhamdulillah, as we used to do, we have that program since last year, since the pandemic started. And alhamdulillah, we can see that everyone, alhamdulillah, enjoying with gathering together for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless that gathering, Allahumma ameen. And it is the chance that we come together, listen to the knowledge, having the dua together, one adhan for the three communities. And let me welcome everyone at the beginning. Let me welcome also Imam Jalal, Imam Masjid al-Rahman in Tarpon Spring. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Shaykhana, kayfa haluk?
Alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Sayyidina Mawlana. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Welcome to you and welcome to everyone, inshaAllah. May Allah bless everyone. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen.
Jazakallah khairan, barakallahu feek. Sorry for the interruption. I don't know if you can hear me, Shaykhana.
Naam, Sayyidina, I can hear you. Yes, sir. I can hear you now, inshallah.
I think there is something happened in the connection, but
alhamdulillah. Yes, but it's back up now, alhamdulillah. Yes.
Alhamdulillah. Barakallah subhanahu wa ta'ala feekum. And inshallah, we used to enjoy, alhamdulillah, I think Imam Yahya, inshallah, is going to join us very soon. And also, Imam, we were talking about some of the characteristics, some of the benefits of Ramadan and some of the characteristics of fasting. That fasting, we come together for 30 days. So can we talk about the wisdom behind fasting? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us Ramadan? And what is the significance of Ramadan?
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Glory be to him. We seek his help and his forgiveness. And welcome to you, my dear respected brothers and sisters. And welcome to Sheikh Imam Ahmed Ali. May Allah bless him and his family. And may Allah bless everyone gathering here. And may Allah Azza wa Jal forgive our sins and gather us together always in Jannah and this dunya in houses of Allah and in the goodness and in the doing or and the, at the obedience, alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, and it, with the good deeds. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Every one of us, my dear respected brothers and sisters, have habit. This habit, it's not a good one. And how we get out, how we control ourselves. Now we said that we are in a month that is shaitan free. We doesn't have no shaitan, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. So we have a habit. For example, some people, they stay, I, honest to Allah, I was one of them, stay in front of the Facebook for like maybe an hour until my head said to me, hey, hello, you know, this is too much. Then I said to myself, let's turn it back, or let's back from face off to faith off. Again, from face off to faith off. Or from, I'm sorry, from Facebook to faith book. The book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything inside the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You control your anger when you are fasting. You control your soul. And you stop from, we used to say, of course, to encourage everyone and encourage each other. Do not steal. Do not look at the haram. Do not stay away from the haram. Stay away from, you know, do not pick up something. It's not belong to you. Do not take something, you know, it's belong to somebody else. But at the month of Ramadan, actually, we take the three halal thing, three lawful thing. We have, alhamdulillah, the food is halal. And we have the water or the drink or the juice, and the juice is halal and the water is halal. And we have, alhamdulillah, enjoy our self with our relationship with our wives, and our wives is halal. But we stop ourselves from doing this halal, you know, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why Allah Azza wa Jalla, He the one who rewards everyone, you know, for from his scale, from the scale of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is important. Look, my dear respected brothers and sisters, sometimes we take online class, or sometimes we are at work, we take course at work. It's meaning this bring more skills for us. How about if we go to training camp, and this training camp for ourselves to get rid of the habits we do not like. Look, you, my dear respected brothers and sisters, look at the relationship between you and Allah when you are alone. When you are alone, with there is no one, you know, with you, like at night time. And that's why it's so important to increase the relationship between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at night time. When there is no one, we cannot show off at this time, because it's just between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first thing in what other, the same thing also other relationship, the first thing they call it is the hidden relationship. Why? Because I can talk to you and you can talk to me, and you don't know if I'm fasting or not, or I don't know if you are fasting or not, except for, of course, in month of Ramadan. So it is very like good chance for us, my dear respected brothers and sisters, to get off to get rid of everything we dislike in ourselves, you know, and to educate ourselves and to control ourselves. The biggest jihad, again, the biggest jihad is your jihad against yourself, against your desire. You know, everyone want to be rich, but why we did not steal? What we did, why we did not steal? You know, afraid from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I know that the time is, I didn't want to exceed my time, my dear respected brothers and sisters. I back to my Imam Sheikh Ahmed Ali. May Allah bless you and bless all gathering. Ameen.
Barakallahu feek, Shaykhana. Jazakallahu khairan. And that is the reality. We said before that there is a great wisdom from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about Ramadan. And why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose Ramadan? Ramadan is a training course. We called Ramadan is the marathon, the competition for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here is another thing I just wanted to share with the three communities. Maybe we mentioned that point, maybe I think yesterday after Fajr, during the Fajr Khatira. But here is that to remind everyone that one of the characteristics of Ramadan, that Ramadan focus and concentrating on feeding your soul and purifying your heart. And subhanAllah, that is the wisdom. We have two parts. We have bodies, we have souls. But one of the things that lots of people have misconceptions about it, that people think that we are bodies which has souls. No. We are souls which are in bodies. So even the bodies that we have right now, that is like a container for our souls. But the souls were created long time ago before you come to the dunya. And your soul will not continue forever. So the soul does not die. The soul does not die. But the soul, when it comes from the body, from the container, then we could say that the body died. But the soul itself goes back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to other world like alam al-barzakh, the world between the dunya and the hereafter, during the time in your graveyard, in your grave, and then in the hereafter, when you live forever, inshallah, in Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of us Jannah. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. So one of the answers, one of the wisdom, but one of the things related to Ramadan, that Ramadan came to tell you, stop feeding your body a little bit and start concentrating on your soul. Because when you start feeding your soul, that soul you will elevate the rank of your soul and you will upgrade your iman. Think about yourself right now, and your relationship with Allah. Surely, definitely, it is better than before Ramadan. Think about at the end of the month of Ramadan. Think about Laylatul Qadr. Think about the last 10 nights of Ramadan. You have a good relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because you started to feed the soul. And day after day, step by step, your level of iman had upgraded, and you reached to the level that you came closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You felt the taste, the sweetness of iman. And alhamdulillah, you saw by yourself that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is kareem. And obeying Allah is not something so hard to handle with. So I think we have to think and to reflect upon the wisdom and the main issue of Ramadan. That Ramadan is, Allah did not give us Ramadan so we can suffer. No, Allah did not give us Ramadan so we can, you know, complain, Imam, I don't have something to eat, I'm starving, I cannot handle this issue. No, Ramadan is more important than this. Ramadan to build your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ramadan is to have that relationship and that helps you to be a better Muslim. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to tell us, give us the example. Allah wanted to give us an idea. If you started to feed your soul the rest of the year, like what you did in Ramadan, so the entire year will be exactly like Ramadan. You will see the blessings of Allah throughout the entire year. And that is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted us to be good Muslims. I told you today about Ramadan is the month of opportunities. So you have chance after chance after chance. And remember that the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ فِي كُلِّ لَيْلَةٍ عُتَقَاءَ مِنَ النَّارِ. Every night, Allah will free some of his servants, some of his slaves from entering the hellfire. Allah will let them, will set them free. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell them, you are not, you will not enter Jahannam and you will enter Jannah directly. So every night, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will choose some of his servants to be away from Jahannam. So 30 nights, 30 consecutive nights, you need to do everything possible and you need to ask Allah, oh Allah, did you choose me this night? Oh Allah, am I one of those people that you said to them that Jahannam will be away from you? You will not enter Jahannam? Oh Allah, am I allowed to enter Jannah? All these questions has to come to your mind. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to be steadfast on his way. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. And I'm looking for Imam Yahya. So I wish if he entered. So I don't think so. I cannot see him. So Imam Jalal, can you see Imam Muhammad? Yes. Okay. So now I can see Imam Muhammad. Yes. So he's a co-host now. Yes. So now you have the control, Imam. Imam, let me come very, very quickly to you to the question before getting back to the dua with Imam Jalal. One of the wisdom, one of the reasons why we have Ramadan, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught us in Ramadan to follow his commands and to abstain even the halal terms. There is a term in Islam, it is called hududullah. These are the rules and the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the prohibition that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us in this religion. What do you think about this idea, Imam Muhammad?
Bismillah wa alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala Sayyidina wa Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Assalamu alaikum everybody. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us in the highest level of Jannah al-Firdaus jami'an, Allahumma ameen. I go directly to the point. The word hududullah, you're going to find it in the verses of Allah in the Quran many times. Usually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, tilka hududullahi fala ta'taduha. These are the limits of Allah, so do not exceed them. Do not transgress these limits. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the rules of siyam, specifically in these verses in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, these are the limits set by Allah, so do not approach, do not come close to them. And there is here a difference between two trends. You know, when you are driving on your way, usually you see this speed limit, let's say like 45. You know, in this case, you are not allowed to exceed these 45. And this is how the Quran goes with all the rules. Do not exceed them. But except in this position, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, even do not come close to these limits. What does it mean? It means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to be pure and wants us to keep us away from any fitna, from any tribulations, from all the trials. And this is how shaitan works. You know, shaitan works hard. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the similar context, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَتَّبِعُوا خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ. Do not follow the steps, do not follow the trials of shaitan. Allah did not say, do not follow shaitan, do not follow the devil. He did not say this in that way. Because it's very clear that shaitan will not come to whisper to me, for example, to say, you know, Islam is not the perfect religion, so leave it and search for another religion. Shaitan will not come from this, you know, from this gate, from this door. But shaitan tries to whisper to you a little bit. Okay, it's time for Salat al-Dhuhr. You still have 3 hours till Salat al-Asr. Go shopping, take a nap. You don't have to pray right now. You still have this long area of time. And then the next prayer comes and the next prayer comes and it gets too difficult for you to pray 5 times, you know, at night when you miss your salawat. What I want to say is that hududullah, the limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah let us know everything in brief and in details. And he told us, do not approach these points, like he says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا. Do not come close to the fornication, the adultery. He did not say, do not commit zina. Because zina, may Allah protect us all, this fornication, this crime, cannot be like suddenly. It has a lot of preparation before it. You know, to have a call and to have, you know, date, and then the boy and the girl, go out for dinner, and then they speak, and then they meet each other, and then, you know, they are taking steps, and they will end up in this fornication. That's why Allah said, do not come close to zina. Do not do what leads you to zina. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to let us know in this verse, تِلْكَ حُدُودُ اللَّهِ فَلَا تَقْرَبُوهَا. These are the limits of Allah, set by Allah, so do not come close to them. Keep yourself away from any fitna, from any tribulations. It has a lot of details, but I think the time is so tight. Alhamdulillah, I think that's enough. I hope it should be clear, inshallah.
Inshallah, one of the things that when the brother Zafwa was raising today, that we wanted to take longer time. He said we wanted to listen to the imam so we can get the knowledge from them. And this is something we can discuss, inshallah, after this session. But what what we need to do. Ramadan is the training course, as Imam Jalal mentioned. It's the training course that you need to feed your soul, that you need to purify your heart. You need to pay attention for the limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not exceed the limits. And inshallah, we wanted to welcome everyone participated, alhamdulillah. But you know what, guys? I'm still asking your favors. We keep like almost the same number every night. That means you did not share the link with everyone. You are getting even lazy, more lazy, and I don't know why. But inshallah, I'm hoping, inshallah, the brothers and sisters will help me. Faisal will help me. Kamal, Firdos, Brother Sharif, Ibtihaz, as usual, and Ali, Brother Noor, our muazzin, inshallah, Abu Abdullah. So we can see, mashallah, inshallah. I'm hoping that you will help me passing the link to everyone, so we will have the entire community. And also Auntie Mariam here with the sisters, the lady groups. I can see, mashallah, lots of brothers and sisters. Sister Moina is here, mashallah. And let me tell everyone, and maybe the brother will feel shy right now before getting to the adhan, but that's my message to him. I can see the name of Brother Rashad. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him. I'm so happy that he joined the virtual iftar, the online iftar, seeing the community members. We are missing him so much, seeing him in the masjid, inshallah. Brother Ahsan, that great job today. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless everyone, ya Rabbil Alameen. Inshallah, let us go back very quickly to Imam Jalal for the dua, and then we will move to Imam Yahya, inshallah.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت، يا رب اهدنا فيمن هديت، وعافنا فيمن عافيت، وتولنا فيمن توليت، وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت، واكفنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت. اللهم تقبل صلاتنا وصيامنا وركوعنا وسجودنا وسائر أعمالنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اشف مرضانا، اشف يا رب قلوبا وأجسادا تتألم على فراش المرض لا يعلمها إلا أنت يا الله. اللهم كن لهم ولا تكن عليهم. اللهم ارحم موتانا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم هيئ لنا عملا طيبا يقربنا إليك يا رب العالمين يا أرحم الراحمين يا كريم. اللهم اكرمنا، اللهم أفض علينا بفيضك الكريم يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وسلم تسليما كثيرا.
بارك الله فيك شيخنا. إن شاء الله إمام يحيى، let's go for the adhan إن شاء الله.
الإمام يحيى خرج الحقيقة عنه خرج.
yes إن شاء الله أذان إن شاء الله إمام جلال.
طيب حاضر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا
إن شاء الله. تبارك الله، جزاك الله خيرا. بارك الله سبحانه وتعالى فيكم
سيدنا، جزاكم الله خيرا وفي الجامع الكريم إن شاء الله. May Allah bless you and accept your good deed إن شاء الله رب العالمين.
يا رب آمين يا رب. تقبل الله منا ومنكم. May Allah accept your salam and آمين يا رب العالمين. جزاكم الله خيرا. Enjoy your meal. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.